Hey guys, welcome to SourceFED. I'm Joe Beretta. Over the past few years, we here at SourceFED have pumped out a couple of stories about advances in cloaking technologies. You can check one out here and one out here. And if you're watching on a device that doesn't allow annotation clickage, you can skedaddle down to the description for a couple of links. The story that I'm spitting out of my mouth spot now covers the latest step forward in the wonderful world of disappearing, and it's a doozy. But it's a fairly simple doozy. Researchers from Rochester University created a cloaking device utilizing four simple lenses. Set up at varying distances on a single plane, light is manipulated and bent as it passes through the quad lens obstacle course, rendering an object invisible. All you need is two sets of lenses with different focal lengths. Simple, yet fascinating, and also a first, according to Rochester University graduate student Joseph Choi, who said, quote, "This is the first device that we know of that can do three-dimensional, continuously multidirectional cloaking, which works for transmitting rays in the visible spectrum. What that means is that whatever object is being shrouded from the eye is invisible from multiple viewpoints. Not all viewpoints, mind you, but more than one, up to 15 degrees. Also cool is that unlike other attempts at Harry Pottering, the background remains undistorted. Unlike when the background is visually molested as the predator takes aim on your cranium with its tri-laser pointer cannon." Arnold was all like, "I don't see you, predator, but I also do see you. It's a visual conundrum." That's a horrible Arnold Schwarzenegger. The system is also cheap. No fancy dancy optic cloth or magic nano iBots here, just lenses. Essentially, the bigger your lenses, the bigger the cloak. Now you may be thinking to yourself, what's the point, Joe? I can't someday utilize this to sneak into Krispy Kreme for secret num-nums. They'll totes see the lenses. And you're right. But researchers do believe this breakthrough could be used in other awesome ways, like installing a system on a semi-truck so the driver can see past his trailer so that he may gaze upon all the angry drivers following behind him. I mean, they could use a camera, but this would be cooler. Or even cooler, a surgeon may one day be able to see through his hands to gaze upon squishy organs that are being diddled. Gross. I would use this in my house so I could take a nap in peace. My kids would be like, "Where's Dad?" And my wife would be like, "I don't know, check behind the four lenses in the living room." And then they'd find me, and then I'd realize I wasted a lot of money on four massive lenses that take up way too much space in my tiny living room. We could also set up an intricate system in space to cloak our planet from invading bad space people that want to hurt us. Guys, explain your feelings concerning these findings in the comments down below, and if you want to make your own cloaking device, follow the links in the description to an explanation on how to make your own. I'm Joe Beretta. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel. That helps us help you. Also, if you're interested, we're going to Chicago on October 10th for DeFranco Does Chicago. I'll be there. Steve Zaragoza will be there. Philip DeFranco will be there. We're going to do a big question and answer variety show thing, and we would love to see your faces. So again, in the description, follow the links, get yourself a ticket, and we'll see you there. I'm Joe Beretta. Thanks for watching SourceFed.